How do I know if I have eyelid ptosis? How is it treated?
Ptosis is a term which means droop. When the eyelid droops, we call it eyelid ptosis. Ptosis or eyelid droop is often referred to as a lazy eye. If you or someone you know has one or both eyes looking partially closed, you may be looking at ptosis. In most situations, the appearance and vision can be improved with ptosis surgery. I'll help you understand what is responsible for the most common types of ptosis, as well as how I work with my patients to formulate a strategy which will have the most likelihood for success. I'm Dr. Amiya Prasad. I'm a board-certified cosmetic surgeon and fellowship-trained oculofacial plastic and reconstructive surgeon. I've been in practice in Manhattan and Long Island for over 20 years. I routinely treat a wide range of ptosis patients in my practice. Many of my patients are patients who've undergone previous ptosis surgery done elsewhere. When I meet a patient with ptosis, I start by reviewing the history to see if you were born with ptosis or if you developed ptosis later. When someone is born with ptosis, it's referred to as congenital ptosis. If you develop ptosis later, it's referred to as acquired ptosis. In either situation, I first establish that there is no neurologic cause for the ptosis before discussing surgical options. Ptosis is essentially the result of a condition affecting the levator muscle. The levator muscle is the muscle that lifts the eyelids, like the word elevator. The type of surgery I recommend depends on the cause of the ptosis as well as the strength of the levator muscle. Surgical correction typically involves either some type of muscle advancement or shortening. If the muscle is too weak, then the surgery is performed to connect the muscle that lifts the eyebrow, called the frontalis muscle, to the eyelid. When patients considering ptosis surgery come to our office, they express a desire to have their eyes look more open and symmetric as much as possibly can be achieved. Very often, people come in requesting cosmetic upper eyelid surgery for sagging skin and don't realize that they have ptosis. During my evaluation, I explain how excess skin over the eyelids, which is referred to as dermatochalasis, is different from drooping of the eyelid caused by the levator muscle, which is, of course, ptosis. There are often times when people have had cosmetic eyelid surgery or upper eyelid blepharoplasty done elsewhere, and they come in concerned that they still look tired. The reason for this is they had upper eyelid skin removed, but nothing was done to address the underlying muscle responsible for their eyelid droop. Most ptosis surgery is performed for acquired ptosis, which is due to a progressive stretching or thinning of the levator muscle. There are some patients who come in saying that they've always had low upper eyelids, which are often referred to as bedroom eyes, and that as time went on, the eyelids became lower and they looked very tired. The objective in surgery is to position the eyelid lifting muscles, which include the levator muscle as well as another muscle called Mueller's muscle, in an advantageous manner to improve the position of the eyelids. I explain to my patients that these muscles are very sensitive and achieving the ideal result can be challenging. This type of surgery is typically performed under local anesthesia with light intravenous sedation. In most cases, I have the patient open their eyes during surgery so I can monitor the height and shape of the eyelid. In fact, I routinely will sit up the patient during surgery and evaluate the appearance of the eyes in a way which more accurately reflects being vertical in real life. This particular aspect of the surgery allows me to anticipate more accurately the outcome we're aiming for. I do qualify the predictability of the procedure with my patients by explaining that 95% of the time the eyes look right and there's a satisfactory outcome. Approximately 5% of the time, enhancements are necessary and are performed when swelling is significantly diminished, which is usually after 3 months. Eyelid swelling is a normal part of the healing process. The extent of the swelling is dependent on the extent of the surgery and the individual patient's physiology. In the first 2 days after surgery, cold compresses help decrease the initial swelling, which occurs right after surgery. After the first 2 days, the clearing of swelling depends on the degree of swelling and your circulation. I encourage my patients to be up and about, walking, talking, smiling, and if they're planning to be more sedentary, warm compresses can help move things along. Most people go back to work in about 1 week. I see our patients routinely more frequently in the first 2 months after surgery, and then in approximately 3 month intervals for a year after surgery. Generally, I expect appearance to be close to the final appearance around 6 months. If a patient has a history of allergies, sinus problems, smoking, or other circulation issues, swelling can persist longer than is typical. Ptosis surgery can have a significant impact in your appearance and your confidence. Functionally, eyelid ptosis can also affect your vision and visual development in children who have it between birth and age 6. If you're questioning whether or not you have ptosis or if you should have surgery, meet with a fellowship-trained oculofacial plastic surgeon and learn about your situation and options. I hope you found this information helpful. Thank you for your question.